from the income.
So you think according to that regulation, pastors are supposed to be regulated by the government?
It's like a teacher, you see, they are like employers, like from the church, but the church has to be controlled by the government.
Okay, now currently, now that the system of Ghana is totally different from that of Germany,
and uncontrolled, for me,
and uncontrolled, I agree with you, You think that is the main reason, that is the main grounds why pastors now have access to people and are able to cheat people for money? Because the pastors need the money to run their church. And they are not getting it from anywhere. So they have turned to the same people that they are supposed to save, and now they are cheating them for the money.
Yeah, they're cheating them. I will tell you how. You see, it's only one example. It was the last, casting spirits out. At the end of the day, it was like asking me, white skin, you have money, give us money. He said, in church, while there was the service running, he asked me in front of all people if I can give money. He said, sorry, sir, but I don't have any money. Because
they asked you in front of the whole church,
if you can
give them money.
Uh-huh. I said,
was it a church in Ghana?
It was a prophet.
Okay, in Ghana?
Yes, of course, myself.
Okay. Apostle.
You see, you know, giving.
Uh-huh.
Giving is very, very essential thing in the household.
Yes, I agree with you.
Giving is a very essential thing in the household. When you give to help the project of a church, you give it to God. You are invested in God. So, when you give money to project the work of God, it will be blessings unto you. Now, and the Bible lets us understand in the book of Hosea, chapter 4, verses, the first statement. He said, out of knowledge my people perish. Because some of the members doesn't learn, or some of the Ghanaians doesn't learn or read the word of God. And that is why sometimes some of the ungodly pastors, they take advantage of them.
Well, let me come in here. Okay.
So, when you go to church, definitely you need to bring your offering to support the church. There are certain churches, they have orphanage homes.
Mm-hmm.
There are certain churches, the members depend upon the church. Some of the churches too, which are like individual churches, there are certain people who also take care of them.
Mm-hmm.
So such pastors, whenever they are taking money to support, or they are taking money, I second them. But there are certain pastors, for them, they will use other tricks to take money from you. Even as she was saying something that, give me money, let me pray for you.
Yeah.
The Bible, Jesus Christ said, when Jesus Christ was sending the people, what did he said, well, I give you, you receive it freely.
Yes.
So you too must what? Give it up freely.
Yes.
You understand?
Yes.
But me, I believe in what is sowing. That I am sowing a seed based upon what I want from God. Yes, me, my man, because in the olden days, I'm coming, mama, wait. In the olden days, when we are going to sacrifice, they don't use money. Maybe if you were a farmer, you bring what?
Your yam,
or whatever it is. You understand me? So that's what the olden days they normally use. But now we don't use those things. We use money.
Yes.
So when you go to the house of God, I want to tell mommy that for money, for offering, it is very important in the house of God. Secondly, tithe is very important because that one was sent by what? God himself. Thirdly, you need to support what? Church activities, such like building, church equipment, electricity bill, water bills, the orphans in the church, the needies, you need to support them. That's why some of the what? Men of God take money. But I started with you that some people take money which some of like, oh, I can see, oh,
yes.
your head is divided in three in the realm of the spirit. So give me money and let me pray for you. That's why I'm saying that lack of knowledge might be possible because they lack knowledge. Do you understand me? But taking money in the house of God, it is not the wrong thing.
Very yet, he has something to say.
I don't agree really.
Well, why don't you agree?
Okay.
Entirely, or you have selected points that you don't agree?
I don't know. You see, I'm following Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ was not asking for money.
Okay. Okay.
I agree the church needs money.
Mm-hmm.
I agree. You see, he spoke about offering, like the seed. Where is the money going? Is it going directly to God? And is multiplying the money, or how? You see, who is controlling this? I'm giving money and they're telling me, I put money into this envelope and it will be 10 times more in your life.
Mm-hmm.
It will not.
Mm-hmm.
Because money is not coming like that. You see, this is a natural law. This is the law of the universe. You can't give money to a church and it is multiplied. No, it's not. And even Jesus Christ, when he is like me going to the church, he will cast them out. He will say, close this money temples. You see, this is not good. This is not good at all. When you have a church,
mm-hmm.
it has to be regulated by the government. It mm-hmm. has to be taxed.
Mm-hmm.
And the people want to give freely to the poor. I'm doing it on my own. I don't need the church to do that. But of course you need organizations. You need maybe like an orphanage, but it has not to be a pastor doing the orphanage. It can be also an organization like an NGO. It has not to be the church. The church can take care about the people in the community.
Okay, so let me ask you this uh-huh. question. How would a church be able to take care of the organizations, their needs, and that of the needy and the poor in the community, if they themselves do not have any means of receiving money?
Okay. Who is responsible? Who is really responsible in Ghana for the needy? Who is really responsible for the poor? Isn't it the government?
Yes, it is.
Okay. Why the church says they have to do it? Of course, they are needy,
yes.
But the pastors are not responsible. The pastors are responsible to spread the word of God. They are responsible to change people's mind, to do better, to be a Christian. But they are not responsible to give the money of the poor to the poor. And they are not giving it. At the end of the day, the people had it to their homes. I was sitting there, and he opened his box.
Mm-hmm.
You can't imagine. He opened his box, took the money out, not even counting or not even taking notes.
Okay.
He took, this is for you, my son, this is for you, my son, this is for you.
So he was sharing it among them?
Yes, and in his own pocket.
Okay, you've already said that. For the sake of time, let me just come in. You said something in your statement that Jesus Christ started a church, but he was not taking money.
Yes.
Have you been reading the Bible?
Yes.
Let me read something from Let me read something from Matthew,
okay.
Chapter 10.
Yes.
Okay, so he says that, you see, in this particular paragraph and in this particular passage, Jesus Christ was sending the disciples to go into the world and preach.
Yes.
Okay, then he said, as you go, preach, saying, the kingdom of God is at hand. Heal the sick, cleanse the leper, raise the dead, cast out evils.
Yeah.
Freely you have received, freely give.
Yes.
So that confirms that what you are saying,
yes.
they are not supposed to take anything.
Yes.
I agree with you. But listen to this. Provide neither gold nor silver nor brass in your purses.
Yes.
In other words, don't take any money with you. He was telling the disciples.
And they are not supposed, and even your preachers are not supposed to have it, and to have golden watches. And
yes. And so yes, I agree with you. But this one, you see, they were traveling, so he warned them that as you are going, don't put money in your pocket, as if you are thinking about how you will feed yourself or you will take care of yourself. Don't take any money with you. Now let's go to the 10th verse.
Mm-hmm.
No scrip for your journey, neither two coats. Neither shoes, nor yet staffs, you mean food.
Uh-huh.
For the workman is worthy of his meat.
Yes.
When he says the workman is worthy of his meat, what he's trying to say is that whoever works deserves to be paid for it.
No, it's not about money. Sorry.
Yes.
It's not about
okay,
money.
Okay.
Okay,
he says the workman.
Yeah.
Is worthy of his meat, what he will eat.
He will feed.
Yes,
feed it by
but we feed with money.
Yes, we are feeding with money, but you see, it's not like
he said. He said, don't take two clothes. Don't take shoes. Don't take extra shoes. But when your cloth is worn out, when your shoe is worn out, you're supposed to replace it.
The Lord will do it.
The Lord will do it. But so okay. So let's listen to the next verse. He says that, and into whatever city or town you shall enter, inquire who in it is worthy, and there abide till you hence, till you go hence.
Who is worthy of the own word? Who is worthy to receive the gospel?
Let your peace come upon it. But if it be not worthy, let your peace return to you.
And when you come into a house suddenly, so you have to greet it. So the horses are greeting, they don't have anything.
Yes.
No money, no golden shoes,
good. I agree with you.
They are going into the houses and they know already who is wealthy to receive the word.
Good.
Who is open minded?
You have been a human being for some time now. I come into your city.
Yes.
I have come to do the work of God.
Yes.
I came with no money, no food, no extra clothing, no extra shoe.
Yes.
And the Lord says I should ask for the one who is worthy. To receive.
Yes.
So I come to you and you are worthy to receive the word of God.
Yes.
So I abide with you. So if I need money, who will give me the money? Because I am doing the work of God. If I need to eat, who will give me the food?
I will give you food.
If I need to change my clothes, who will help me?
I will give you clothes.
If I need to change my shoes, who will help me? Have you been buying shoes and clothes for your pastor?
Not from the pastor. He's getting money.
From where?
He's getting money from the
pastor. But according to you, if you are to follow this system.
From the tents. He's getting
money. Where is the tent coming from?
From the people, but directly from the income. Only from the people from the income.
That is in your community. In our community, when I work, the money is paid into my accounts, and an amount is deducted for the government, not for the church.
Yes, but this is a system.
So for us to correct the system, we need to turn to the people whose responsibility it is, because it is the people who are worthy of the word.
Yes,
they have received the word. And the monies that the people are getting, do you also know that the people on the street, some of them, they are not actually, their incomes are not deducted by the government?
Yes, I know. So they can't give.
So when they go to church, it is their obligation to also help the church and give.
No, they can't. You have to help them. You have to provide for them. You have to take care about the poor.
Which one? The church or the pastor?
Everybody has to.
Okay, so currently, the problems we have identified, number one, is that the pastors are not being regulated.
Yes.
There are too many of them.
Yes.
And most of them are not qualified to be pastors.
What I see since I'm here and the 3 months I was already here.
Yes.
Some are qualified, but even this qualified taking advantage of women.
Even the qualified ones are taking advantage of people.
You see, I'm like a psychologist already. You see, I studied a little bit beside and I know what they're doing.
What are they doing?
You see, it was in Prokopite, it was near Prokopite. It was like, okay, there were almost only women, poor women, and they did it like a game. You see, there are 3 or 4 times they were like dancing, putting money, having fun, in a nice way.
Yes.
But the preaching was only about money. It was really only about out of the Bible, through the Bible.
They only selected quotations that about giving money.
And it was a big banner about.
Maybe at that particular season that you went there, they were raising funds for a project.
Every church I was in is like that. Sorry. Every church I went in was like a big banner. Quarter one, quarter two, quarter three, quarter four.
Okay, I agree with you. So even the qualified ones are taking advantage of the system and they are robbing people.
This
robbery that you are talking about, where can we establish it? Is it in the tithing? Or is it in the offering, or it is in the fundraising and free will offering?
I can't even say
you
so.
Can't identify
it can't identify because there are really it was a game. You see, I will tell you the
it's a game. There are some of your views that even Apostle and I have agreed with.
Yes.
But the truth of the matter is, one, we need to establish that in the first place, it is right for people to pay tithe.
Yeah.
Right. Number two, it is right for people to pay offering.
Yes.
And to contribute to
but
church.
But what they can do, not yes. what they have to do, not to ask about 500
pounds. What do you mean by what they can do and what they have to do? What they have to do is what they are doing, right?
No, you see, I was in a, I don't know the name anymore, it was here in our place here, Tabora. Okay, I had it last Sunday, I was in one church, I can't even tell you the name, I don't know. It was like, they took me directly in front of the pastors. You see, white skin, she has money, but I don't know.
So some of the church.
I'm coming. So I was sitting there, and he started to okay. You see, we have the goal, X epsilon goal. I'm asking you, who is giving 500 Ghana cedis?
Okay, I understand that one. So that practice.
Okay, who is? And it was you see, you take them under pressure, even the one having some money. They're looking around, okay.
So it has turned into a competition.
Yeah, it's a competition. No? And they stand in front and was celebrating yoo-hoo like this, yes, applause.
Mm-hmm.
I was okay. And then who is giving 200? Who is giving 100? And after this 100, I stood up and I left the place because this is not preaching the gospel. Sorry.
Okay, I agree with you. Apostle, what do you think about that? Do you understand what she's talking about?
I understand her, but I am saying that maybe.
That is about the seed sowing.
Yeah, maybe they are sowing the seed.
Yes, that is the seed sowing. I think it is the seed sowing.
Maybe.
But do you agree with that approach of seed sowing?
Oh yeah, I agree.
They announce those
they
who
announce
want to.
If you can afford, that's why I am saying the lack of knowledge, my people's worry. If you know you don't have money, you know that the money that I have is meant for something else. And even when giving out without what feeling it or having the good heart to give, you know you know.
Okay, so yes.
Wait, I'm coming. So
we need to wrap up.
You need to wrap up. So what I mean is, what happened over there? I see nothing wrong about it. But I see nothing wrong about it. But you giving out now. Maybe you think you can give. That is what you give.
Okay, so even if you think you can give,
yeah,
you think the approach is right.
I think the approach is right.
Okay, brilliant. What do you think?
Okay, you see, when you're bringing the people into such situation, they will give, of course. But yes. When you are writing a letter on Sunday for the next Sunday, please, we are collecting for this particular project.
That is excellent.
In
but that one, do you know?
In front of the people.
Yes.
This is my neighbor. He's supposed to be.
But then that one, brilliant. Have you noticed that even the big churches on international networks, televisions, mm-hmm. they all do that. They stand.
But they're not asking you give me 500.
No, they do it. They announce that if you can sow a seed of 500, uh-huh. if you can sow a seed of $10, if you
wrong.
Can...
They're wrong. All these big churches are wrong. And you see, I know this preacher...
But how will the church be able to write to you the unknown?
Okay.
The church is preaching through the network. A network.
They're collecting my email address. Every church is asking me, what is your email address?
I want to give you about 2 minutes.
Yes.
Advise the Ghanaian church. Especially the leaders and the people of the church.
I would first of all, I would advise your president.
The president, okay, we are listening.
Akufu Addo. Advise him to take control about the churches, over the churches.
Yes, the church leadership.
The church leadership and the churches in. You see, all these churches, they are not under control. You see, you have so many different churches. I don't think that the government knows all about the churches here
yes,
in Ghana.
Yes, it is
so,
true.
And they have to be registered. They have to be registered. And particular people collecting money are doing this church. They have to be in a database.
Okay.
Now you have to know them. You have to know them. And even your assemblymen, even your MPs, they have to know them. They have to be in a database. And it has to be going to the government, or if he can do it like in Germany, they have the churches, but not 20 different, heading to the United States, to UK, or whatever, because of the history, they're heading to other countries. Why does it depend on other countries? Why you can't have a church in Ghana or in Africa? Why it has to be the Pentecost, the Methodist? Why they have to do this? They don't have to do this. When you are a man of God, when you are really a man of God and following Jesus Christ, you don't depend on Europe, on the United States, or on the UK. You don't depend on anybody.
It's not only
about the church, it's about the whole economy, it's about the whole country. They depend on someone else and they take advantage. It's not about the church only, they take all advantage about Ghana and the whole Africa. They are robbing you.
Okay.
And you see, it's not about only the church. I know a lot of companies, I know the governments, even the German governments, they're not thinking so good when they're doing contracts. Huh? I was listening to them. The prophet is in our country. The prophet is not in Ghana. It's like
all right. What about, do you have any form of advice directly for the church pastors? Especially those ones that you have identified to be cheating people.
Oh, they have to repent. They have to return to Jesus Christ.
They are not with Jesus Christ.
No, they are not. Especially people or pastors, they are doing... You see, they know what they are doing.
Yes, I understand.
Okay. You see, they know exactly what they are doing. And
yes.
You see, I know Jesus Christ is coming soon. The judgment day is coming soon.
Yes, I understand.
They have to repent and they have to return.
What about the common people? The churchgoers, the people on the streets, what do you have to say for them?
I wouldn't trust anybody anymore.
They shouldn't trust people.
No.